It is Christmas time in the late 19th century at the von Staubach home. Excitement runs high as Mrs. Staubach prepares the invitations for friends and family to celebrate the annual Christmas Eve party. Excitement fills the air as Clara and Fritz watch the house being decorated with wreaths and garlands. All the while, the postman delivers parcels and packages to doorsteps throughout the town. Thank you. The guests begin to arrive for the celebration with Clara, Fritz, and their parents. Festivities open with celebratory music as everyone starts to dance. All the children anxiously run through the crowded room as they anticipate the moment they can finally open their Christmas gifts. Everyone except for Clara, who receives a mysterious gift from her godfather, Dr. Drosselmeyer. It is a crystal star that seems to have frightening magical powers. Thank you. Festivities come to an abrupt pause as a mysterious figure enters the room. It is Dr. Drosselmeyer. Drosselmeyer is a very talented toy maker and brings with him three lifelike dolls, Harlequin, Columbine, and a soldier.
Thank you.
Drosselmeyer has one more gift for each of his godchildren. Fritz quickly opens his gift and gallops away, delighted with his new stick horse. Claire opens her gift, a little wooden nutcracker carved in the shape of a toy soldier. Jealous that Clara had received a better gift, Fritz grabs the nutcracker from her and, in the struggle, breaks the nutcracker, leaving Clara heartbroken over her mysterious little soldier. Late. As all the party guests leave the celebration with their drowsy children, Clara falls into a deep sleep while her Nutcracker doll stands guard over all of her new toys. At the stroke of midnight, Clara wakes up to a frightening scene. The house, the tree, and the toys seem to be getting larger. Out of nowhere, large mice, led by their mouse king, begin to circle the room while her toys come to life. Thank you. king traps the nutcracker in the corner, and the nutcracker can't overcome the mouse king's strength. Clara makes a desperate move to save her nutcracker from defeat by throwing her pillow at the mouse king. The nutcracker defeats the stunned mouse king and claims victory. The mice army quickly retreats, carrying away their king. The nutcracker transforms into a prince and leads Clara through a moonlit forest filled with delightful music, dancing snowflakes, and the enchanted Snow Queen. Thank you. Before sending them on their journey, the Snow Queen presents Clara with a beautiful tiara. With a twirl of the magical crystal star, the two travelers are off to the land of the sweets. Soon, snow-covered trees become trees covered in sweets and towering lollipops. A glittering angel appears and greets all who enter the magical realm. Thank you. her Majesty, the Queen of Sweets, who welcomes the Nutcracker, the Prince of this land, and Clara into her beautiful kingdom. As the Queen's subjects arrive to welcome them, the Nutcracker tells everyone of his battle with the fearsome Mouse King and how the brave and selfless Clara saved him. For Clara's courageous act, the Queen of Sweets declares her an honored guest at her court and orders a royal celebration of dances in her honor. Clara and the Nutcracker take to the throne. The first to dance for Clara are the Spanish chaplains. In a display of lively leaps and turns, they dazzle the court with their spirited steps and the rhythm of castanets. Thank you. Next come the mysterious Arabian coffee. The dancers enchant everyone with their elegant and languid movements in a spellbinding dance. A visit from Mother Ginger surprises all, when from beneath her enormous skirt appear her darling little bonbons of sugar and spice that bid a delighted Clara to join them in their dance. Chinese tea next floods the chamber with a flourish of color as the dancers arrive to celebrate their guests. Their patterns of fans and silks take Clara's breath away. Next arrive dainty mirlitons with their reed flutes. Their tune, sweet as marzipan, plays as they dance gracefully in the chamber. Thank you. Then, in a flash, come dancers jumping and turning in a Russian tree pack. They leap and spin in peppermint twirls that nearly make Clara dizzy. Nutcracker turns to Clara and asks her to dance. As they step down from the throne, the beautiful dewdrop fairy arrives. A sweet perfume fills the air as she beckons her many flowers to dance the grand waltz of the flowers. Thank you. After waltzing among petals of every color in the rainbow, a tired Clara returns to the throne as the grand pas-de-deux appears in a romantic dance that makes Clara's heart flutter. Thank you. Sugar Plum Fairy arrives lastly, shimmering like a jewel. Clara watches her admiringly as the Sugar Plum Fairy dances gracefully, as if on air.
Thank you.
The Nutcracker himself dances to honor his dear Clara and to celebrate her coming to the kingdom. Finally, all the subjects in the land of sweets join together in a closing celebration. They fill the room with merriment and joy as they dance. Thank you. In all the excitement, Clara finds herself suddenly very sleepy. Her eyes flutter shut as the music becomes more and more distant, and she falls into a peaceful slumber. She opens her eyes to find herself home again, her wooden nutcracker steadfastly by her side as she touches her head, smiling as she feels the tiara still upon it. How magical her night was in the land of sweets! She picks up her dear nutcracker and clutches him. She smiles at him, and he seems to smile back. What a precious gift from her godfather Drosselmeyer, a gift that she will cherish always.
It's the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know and everyone you meet. Ho, ho, toe hung where you can see. Somebody waits for you, kiss her once for me. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, oh by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year.
Have a holly jolly Christmas, it's the best time of the year.
Have a holly jolly Christmas, and when you walk